Okay, so right now we're on the edge of a seamount. It comes up to about 200 metres on the top, and I'm just surveying the edge of it where it drops off into deeper water. So I'm running my DFF3 transducer, 2 kilowatt. Of course, low frequency. As soon as I get over 200 metres of water, I'm running the low frequency. Now, the settings I've got on at the moment, I've got it on auto fishing, and that seems to be clearing up a lot of the clutter. I can go into the main settings, and I take a look at the sounder. So, all of my standard colours are set up. Transmit rate, I've got it cranked right up to 20, because we just want to be getting as many pulses down as possible. So, you can run it on auto, and it will adjust. I turn mine onto manual and I just leave it cranked up. A little bit more battery power, but you know you're pumping the maximum amount of beams down, so you're getting the maximum amount of data back. Transmission power also cranked up to 10. Now the gain offsets. So I can adjust the offset up and down. So when I adjust my gain, it just puts more weighting either way. I'm in auto at the moment, so my auto gain on low frequency, I've got cranked right up to +4. So if you're on manual, you've got to constantly be adjusting your gain, which is fine, but then you've also got to be adjusting your TVG, which basically takes out its time varied gain. So as you're pumping maximum power down, you're picking up more noise in the shallower water, and that can give you a lot of clutter at the top. Now the auto here is cleaning up that to a large degree. A lot of this sort of stuff's noise, I'm not terribly worried about that. But I can see a large shoal of fish just on the edge here. And on the bottom lock, which gives me more details, I've got that set to look at the bottom 50 meters of water. There's a nice dark patch right there. So we've also got frequency adjust. Now I can adjust the frequency that my two transducers are firing out. So at the moment, when it's in the middle, it's set to 38 kilohertz. I can adjust that down to about 32 kilohertz, or I can sort of bring it up to 42, 44 kilohertz. I find that just leaving it at 38 while we're in this sort of depth is fine. Once I get out beyond say 400 or 500 meters, I lower the frequency because a lower frequency gets better penetration. We've also got our pulse length as well. So there's lots of settings you can change. Basically, my transmission pulse, I can choose short one, short two, standard or long. Now, basically, the shorter the pulse, the more of them going down, so the higher the definition. But also, the less effective they are at traveling through deep water. So I've just got it set to standard, and I'm getting a really clear picture in this depth of water here at the moment. Now, if I come back to the main menu, you'll see the setup that I've got on the screen here. Now, you'll see here I've got it on bottom lock. Now, this displays my full water column on the right-hand side. On the left-hand side, it gives me a snapshot of 50 meters. Now I can adjust what my bottom lock looks at, but I like to look at the bottom 50 meters when I'm out here looking for blue nose and harp hooker, because sometimes they can be well up off the bottom. And just as I'm coming around here, you can see on the bottom, in fact, we can wind back through the history here. Now, this here corresponds, and this is where the bottom lock sort of paid off for me. I've got all of this sort of bait and feed down here on the edge. But at this particular point here, you can see it's really dark and concentrated. So I've got a good mark, so I can just touch that now. New point. Anything that I'm checking out, I choose to mark it as a flag until I can go back and confirm it. And you can see that there, that dark patch is represented on my plotter. But that was good enough for me. The thing to do now is work out our drift direction. I can move up, we can run some baits through that concentration of marks. And well, it looks like a couple of predators down there as well. And we'll see if that's target species.